hardware needed for this side. Here we have your frame support bolts. This is your cross beam bolts. These are your impact pad bolts.
And two washers on each.
Okay. Now we're going to prep the wrench and nut. Note the orientation. Okay, here we are prepping our wrench and nut. What I'm doing is I'm taking the wrench with the flange nut that's taped on to the wrench, inserting it into the frame and the oval. Now you take your finger, align the threads.
Go ahead. So now you want to have one person turning the socket and another holding the wrench in place.
Okay. Good.
Makes life a lot easier. Now you'll want to tighten the bolt, 250 foot-pounds.
Go ahead.
Get as much leverage as you can.
There you have it.
And it's tightened. So after you torque down the bolt, you'll just want to back it off just a hair.
At the same time, push up on the wrench just so you can get the wrench out.
So now you'll want to repeat the same process through the oval on the inside of the frame to the other side. Side, have someone hold the wrench from the inside and the other person on the socket and just keep tightening it down. So now again, you want to torque it down 250 foot-pounds. On the driver's side, you have two options. You can either drop the gas tank down to get out the bolt, or you can go ahead and cut it, but remember you are next to a gas tank, so use discretion. Okay, so for the driver's side, you'll have a couple brake lines. You just want to unclip those from their harness. Just bend them up and out of the way. Be sure not to kink them, be a little careful with them.
Put a wrench in on the driver's side.
Keep the orientation of the nut on the wrench just like you did on the last one. This side can be a little bit trickier just because of the brake lines. Alright, so one thing we just did, we went ahead and removed the clip that you see here that was holding the brake lines on. It can kind of get in the way a little bit, so you just want to remove it from the truck for right now. Okay, so once you have everything lined up, you just want to go ahead and repeat this side just like you did on the passenger. Just get it nice and tight, and you want to apply once again 250 foot-pounds of torque, and it helps if you start on the rear of the car first, not the front. Alright, so now you'll want to repeat on the front side of the truck as well, like you just did on the back, 250 foot-pounds.
Now we have the crossbeam bolts. Start with the rear one, or pardon me, the inside one, in and through. In and through. Washer and nut on the back side, on each.
So now you want to loosen the rear bolt and take apart the shackle. My friend Andrew here is doing.
You got one more in you?
Yeah.
Okay, so what you want to do is install the shackle from the factory that you just took off. Just transfer it right over to the national spring. Make sure it's angled the same way and pointed the same way.
The shackle goes on to the single wrap end.
Does it matter where I have this angled at while I'm tightening it?
Don't tighten it all the way.
Okay.
Yes, it does.
Perfect.
Oh, it's good. So now what we want to do is put them in upside down like that.
And then roll them on
up over.
There it is. But they're not in those holes.
That's okay. They gotta come out. Just put that one in first. Put the front hole in first. There you go.
That's the front.
Okay, just put that one in. Now slide the rear bolt in.
And we want it nut out to us, right? Or you want nut in?
Nuts on the inside. Bolts through, put the nuts on, but don't tighten them down.
Okay. This is going under.
Now we do the impact pad. This goes in between the rear end and the leaves.
Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Hold back.
Now we're putting the impact pad in. Support underneath.
Underneath here, you want to make sure your bolts, the holes are lined up in the pad so they slide up on in. Let's see what that looks like when you remove it. Now go ahead and put your U-bolts in.
Large thick washer first, then lock washer, then nut. Okay, get them all started about evenly, and then we'll come back and torque them down.
So now everything should be all flushed in. Mm-hmm. Try to evenly get the bolts up in there, so the bottom.
Just hand tight right now. We'll come back in and torque them once we get everything loaded.
All right, so you take out your rear
jack stands
and
so your rear end can droop out more. Now we're going to put in top shock bolt first. Come down to the bottom. Come down, please. Some more on the rear end.
So make sure once you're done putting those two bolts in, get the nut on the back side and do not tighten it at this point.
Due to the bushings that are in the shock absorbers, you don't want to tighten the entire rear suspension until it's in a neutral position. Now we just need to take off the cap. Jam that. This pin goes inside that hole. Tighten down the nut. Cap on. Now that we've jacked up the rear end to a neutral position, so the truck is mostly on the jack underneath the rear end, our rear end is now in a neutral position. This is when we tighten down all of the bushings, U-bolts, etc. Refer to the installation instructions for torque values.